Welcome back. So when I click on one here, two here, it has to be displayed over here in the input expression. Okay, there is no direct way of doing this in Bubble. So let me introduce a concept called custom states. Okay, so I will select the group. I will click on this I button here, and I can create a new custom state. Okay, let me create a new custom state called expression. I'll choose the state type to be a text. Okay, and I'll say create. Okay, before we move on, let me make you understand what we're trying to exactly do here. Okay. So this is the custom state that we created, and I have named it as expression. Okay, and this is the text expression, the input that we need to display on the screen. 1 + 5 + -2. 1 + 5 - 2. Okay. So now this is the input that we need to enter, right? 1, 2, 3. Whatever I input, I have to set the custom state with that value here. So for example, let's say I press 1. It gets added here, and when I press plus, okay, it should be appended to the existing state. So I will say 1 is the existing state, and I'll append plus to it. Now when I press 5 here, again it has to be appended to 1 plus, and then 5 we will append. Similarly, we will append the minus and 2. Okay, that is what we have to do when we press. We have to set the custom state and also append it to the existing custom state. That is the first step. Now we need to display this expression, this custom state, onto the screen. That we do by dynamically binding the custom state to the text expression. So let's see this in action. Okay. So first let me go to the text one and start a workflow. So when text one is clicked, what should happen? I should set the state, correct? So what is the state? So the group is A, okay? In the group A, I have created a custom state called expression. And what is the value we should set? I should append to the existing value, right? So I will again go to group A, expression, append. Then I will append a arbitrary text. The text is 1 in this case, right? Now let me go back to 2, start a workflow. I will do the similar thing. Set state. Group A, expression. Then what is the value? Group A's expression, we will append an arbitrary text, that is 2. Okay. I'll go to 3. I'll start the workflow. I'll add an action. Set state. Group A. Expression. Group A expression. I'll append an arbitrary text. 3. Okay. I will not do it for the rest of, for just for the time being. Let's add these symbols, okay, these operators. So add, set state, group A, expression, group A, expression, append arbitrary text, plus Close it. I'll do it for one more operation, that is the subtraction. Set state, choose group A custom, group A expression, I'll append what? I'll append an arbitrary text for negative symbol. Alright. Now, the step that we have completed is, so when we enter an input, we are appending and we are setting the custom state. Now the next step is, I need to dynamically bind this custom state to the text expression so that it gets displayed on the screen. Okay, let's do that. So here, okay, so instead of this static text, I will insert dynamic. So what is the dynamic thing that I need to enter? Group A's expressions, correct. That is the value that I want to enter. And let's do one more thing while we are at it. So instead of aligning it towards left, I will align it towards the right. So I will align it towards right. All right. So let's see this in action. I'll preview. Okay, I'll enter one. You can see the input coming over here. It's a plus. Is it 2? Okay, we are not yet evaluating. Okay, so there is no result coming till now. So I can say minus 3. Okay, it works. Yeah, in the next video, we will see how to calculate the result. Stay tuned. See you in the next one.